Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to our KRQE.com webcast on this Veterans Day. We begin with Kristen Van Dyke and the forecast. Hi, Kristen.
Good afternoon. A lot of cloud cover around today, but we won't see any shower activity, and temperature is actually a little bit warmer than yesterday. And with the cloud cover around tonight, it will be chilly, but not as cold. We shouldn't dip down to the freezing mark here in the metro area tomorrow morning, and then tomorrow afternoon, actually a little bit warmer. We're talking 70s and 80s out east, and highs in the low 60s for the metro. The only catch is the winds are really going to be increasing tomorrow, especially along the central mountain chain and out east, where winds could gust to 50, 60 miles per hour there, and even fairly windy conditions for the metro. 30 to 40 mile per hour winds are possible there. A couple of disturbances moving our way that will mean snow for the San Juan tomorrow afternoon. The second system moving in will mean the chance for a little bit of rain for the metro on Sunday, and the chance for some showers down across the south and southeast as we head into the early part of next week. 7-day forecast here, highs in the 50s today, 63 tomorrow and windy, and then the cooler weather moves in. We dry things out and clear things out on Monday with highs in the 50s and lows in the mid 30s.
Thank you, Kristen. Police say a man who caused a fatal accident last night in Albuquerque was drunk. Court documents also indicate his license is revoked and he had prior DWIs. Investigators say 25-year-old Andrew Delgado had been stopped by police for speeding and weaving around 1 last night. Before the officer could get in his vehicle, he says Delgado ran a red light at San Antonio and Pan American and T-boned another car. 59-year-old Daniel O'Daniel died at the scene. 3 others were hurt. Delgado was injured and was hospitalized, but now he's at MDC. A 22-year-old man is charged with stabbing another guy outside the launch pad in downtown Albuquerque. Eduardo Barros is charged with aggravated battery and a probation violation. He had been tased and had to go to the hospital, but he was booked into MDC. Police say Barros and the victim got into an argument just before midnight at 6th and Central. Cops say the unidentified victim was in his 20s. He was taken to UNM Hospital with non-life-threatening injuries. Well, stay with KRQE for more news and weather updates throughout the day, and a big thank you to all of our veterans today.